गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंडक्ट द रेफ्रिजरेशन टेस्ट. द टॉपिक ऑफ दैट इज टू स्टडी अबाउट द डिफरेंट रेफ्रिजरेशन डिवाइसेस इन विच वर्क्स ऑन द वेपर कंप्रेसर रेफ्रिजरेशन सिस्टम. सो व्हाट इज दिस? दिस इज ए एयर कंडीशनिंग डिवाइस. नाउ व्हाट इज एयर कंडीशनिंग डिवाइस? व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द एयर कंडीशनिंग डिवाइस देन व्हाट इज एयर कंडीशनिंग? इट इज अ डिवाइस विच इज यूज टू मेंटेन द टेम्परेचर, ह्यूमिडिटी, सर्कुलेशन ऑफ एयर एंड प्यूरिफिकेशन ऑफ एयर. इफ समवन से that refrigeration is used to, for cooling purpose only, then it is wrong. The refrigeration is a device which is used to maintain the temperature, that is important thing, and to maintain the humidity and to purify the air and circulation of air. That's why we use, there is the four devices. In their refrigeration devices, there are, it works on the vapor compression refrigeration cycle. When we talk about in vapor compression refrigeration cycle, then there are mainly four parts. First is called the compressor. It may be reciprocating or rotary compressor. And which gas or which refrigerant we use here, that is the important thing. Nowadays, we are using the R134A. Initially, we preferred the R22, but nowadays we are using the R134A, because it is a friendly refrigerant. Now, after that, that is the important thing, then which is the important of the compressor, then we use the condenser. That is the backside of that refrigerant, that is called the condenser. And that condenser, after that, we use the capillary tube. That is the important thing, that is the capillary tube. This is called the capillary valve. This is, condenser is there. Inside of that device, that is called the condenser. That is, we can say, outside part of the window AC, that is called the condenser. Then we use the expansion valve. That is called the expansion valve, that is the capillary tube. Here we use the capillary for that purpose. Then, this is, this part is called the evaporator coils. These are the evaporator coils. The coils of evaporator is depend on the capacity of that refrigerant. That refrigerant number of coils increase due to the capacity increase. Now this is the, we use the rotameter. That is the measurement device, rotameter measurement device. Then here mention voltmeter, ammeter. Then this is the main switch. When we start that, then the AC will be run. Then this is the unit called air conditioner. This is the meter. How energy meter. That is how energy consume in rotate the refrigeration device. This is the compressor switch. When we use that, then this compressor is started. Then compressor is started. Initially start with low pressure, low temperature vapor refrigerant enter into the compressor, where it compress and change into the high pressure and high temperature vapor refrigerant. That high pressure and high temperature vapor refrigerant enter into the condenser. And what happens in condenser, it gives up this latent heat to the surrounding and change into the liquid form. And then liquid enter into the capillary tube. Here, pressure of temperature of that liquid will be high. But when it enter into the capillary tube, then it expand and pressure and temperature of that liquid will be decreased. Then it again enter into the evaporator coils. These are the evaporator coils. What happens in evaporator coils? In evaporator coils, this low pressure, low temperature vapor refrigerant absorbs heat from the surrounding. What is it like? The surrounding, this is the surrounding. It absorbs the heat from the surrounding and change into the vapor form. This low pressure, low temperature vapor again enter into the compressor and again convert into the high pressure and high temperature vapor and cycle is completed. That is called the vapor compression cycle. Why we call it vapor compression cycle? Because low pressure and low temperature vapor refrigerant convert into the high pressure and high temperature vapor refrigerant into the compressor. That's why it is called the vapor compression refrigeration cycle. How we measure the COP? That is the coefficient of performance of that refrigeration device. That is called the coefficient of performance. What is the coefficient of performance? Coefficient of performance is heat extract to the worker. What is the heat extract? It means how much refrigeration effect is produced, that is called the heat extract, and how much work done by the compressor. The ratio of that is called the coefficient of performance. Here we use the suction gas and discharge gas. The suction gas is where pressure, it is the pressure. Where we measure the suction, how much air is sucked into the compressor. And discharge at the end of the this, where it enter into the suction. This is called the discharge pressure. So we take both pressure, suction pressure and discharge pressure. According to that, we find the refrigeration effect and work done. That is the important thing of that. This is the low pressure, high pressure output, cut out. It means when low pressure decrease, then it cut out, or if high pressure is increased, then it is cut out. That is the important thing. Here we use two devices, that is the expansion valve and the capillary tube. If load is maximum, then we use the expansion valve, and when load is zero, then we use the capillary expansion valve. When high capacity refrigeration devices are used, then we prefer the expansion valve. Otherwise, you prefer the capillary loop. In our domestic refrigerator, we prefer the capillary loop. So this is the main of the vapor compression refrigeration cycle, how it works. This is the refrigerator. This is the refrigerator. These are the fins which is used for increase the surface area. Right. And this points depend on the capacity of the refrigerator. So due to this, we can say after that many students are able to understand what which cycles prefer in vapor in refrigerator or in air conditioning. So we can say after that student are able to understand that how air refrigeration is work. Okay.